Oh my God. Oh my God. You can see this. You can see my face right now, right? Like just the ability that it actually created that. Just crazy, right? That's super fun. Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to put O3 versus O4 mini in a single video. We're going to test the models on real tasks. I'm going to do most of them in one shot because I want to understand how easy it is for someone to write a couple of lines more and get a better result from a newer model. So let's put them to the test. On the left hand side, I have O3 and on the right hand side, I have O4 mini, right? So you have the O3, this is the bigger model, the bigger beast of everything. And this is the quick one which we're going to test out. The first task is very simple. Act as a design engineer, learn about the Notion company design fundamentals, create a design documentation based on the collections around the web, create a beautiful landing page and make sure that all of this is in a single file. I'm going to activate search if they need to. Technically, O3 should be able to automatically activate it and just press enter. Now, I wanted to do two things. Go ahead and search the web, then create a documentation. And then the third step being probably go ahead and write the final landing page. And as you can see, they both have started thinking, right? And you can see like, you know, O4 mini is much more faster given that like, you know, it's also started thinking, but it has already started doing a couple of things here and there, right? So, and given that I've activated search here, it's already gone and started searching the web, trying to get the details and everything else. This is just the beauty on how fast O4 mini is. You can just see on the steps that it has taken. Right now, you can see it's still interpreting the request on the left-hand side. I believe it did not go ahead and search. That's what I think. It did not go ahead and search the web actually, right? Let's see what really comes out better. One thing is that this came in a canvas, which is really good because it did understand that I am writing code. Okay, let's say allow selected access. This is a one-shot landing page using the same design style of Notion. This looks really, really good. Given that it's one shot, it has also taken the name of my agency from the chat that we have been having. And then given that it is super clean and it is done in one shot, I am just blown away. I'm really just blown away. You can see that on my face. And then I'm going to ask it to put this code in a canvas so that we can preview this inside and to see that, like, you know, again, and see actually how much does it change when you search using O4 mini and did much more research compared to O3. But let's say I also give it the same task, search more about design style about Notion and redevelop the page. And if I go ahead and, like, you know, technically give it the search option, which it should have triggered, you see this is what O4 mini came up with. Now just imagine O4 did not even go out, just very simple design styles, but this is what O3 came with and this is what O4 mini came with. And you can see that O3 actually does stand out in programming and really following instructions very well. Perfect. The design is updated by O3 with the new web inputs and this is what it has come back with. I think it has just taken a couple of design elements as being black and white from Notion. Nothing random, like, you know, just probably a couple of animations here and there. It's pretty good, but I actually like my previous design much better. So again, it did not really help. I can expand it to show the web better so that it's not like there are any errors or such. But again, it did a decent job. Something like that could have done. But just given the idea that they are able to create this in one shot, just blows my mind. Still just blows my mind that you were able to put in a couple of messages, landing page, similar to your website or something like that. I actually want to do one more task. What if we ask it to replicate something in Airbnb style? Airbnb website style. And you can see it's super good. Just imagine this was one shot. I started to do it in Airbnb style and it was able to do this. Like, again, it's not perfect at any go. If you are able to use it as a normal user without thinking a lot, then you can actually test if the models have gone better. Using older models on this would not have resulted in a decent design. I want to do a bit more understanding of, okay, what can we push it to? Now, this is the new prompt. Act as a data research analyst. I'm going to give it this massive set of data, which is all the income tax data for India, and then ask it to do three steps. Create a chart, create a beautiful image explaining the real estate, create a beautiful image explaining the real estate of India wealth distribution, and then finally write a social media post. So it's going to do three things and I'm just going to copy and paste this. Start a new chart. Always start a new chart when you're testing models so that you can actually see if they were able to do something great. I'm attaching this and then I'm just going to paste this. I'm going to come here and upload another file, quickly attach the income tax return data here, and then paste this both of these things and technically give them off to the race. I want to start them at the same time, so actually see how quicker O4 Mini comes out to be. Okay, let's see. I think, you know, in this, I really expect O3 will excel no matter what, given that it did in the previous task also, just based on how good the model is. But also, I want to see how much difference in a more mathematical-based conversation, like from a chart perspective, it would be faster if O4 Mini just gives me the charts much faster, right? Because again, it's not going to change a lot. And if the charts are pretty close to both of them, then we can just use either or. But one thing you'll see, I really love this whole, like, you know, like I've started loving this much more, the kind of thought process that they were running. So I can easily see that O4 Mini has already started writing all the Python code to create the chart. But also that I think the system prompt has changed a lot. The prompt has just got much better. The quality of response looks much better. And that could be due to multiple reasons, right? So let's see. I am just waiting for the result to actually see. And I'm going to collapse this so I actually see what's happening for user. And I think it has already started and created also a couple of charts which will be visible to me in a second or are already visible. And it's gone on to the next task. O4 Mini is too fast. O4 Mini is just super fast. And let me reduce the size so I can see all the things that are happening. So this is the chart, right? I think this one did not load up properly or something. Or a wealth concentration like a table, right? So you have the table as top 1% has 41.7%, top 5% has 56%, top 100% has 62% of the wealth. And it's the same, the chart loaded pretty quickly, right? And given the idea that the chart is loaded pretty quickly, it's really great, right? Really great, you can use it and XYZ. And can I interact? Yes, I can interact on this. And that's one of the cool features of ChatGPT, not such of the model. But share of gross total income, and then you can see top 10% owns 62% of the wealth, and bottom 90% owns just this. But this is probably where, like, you know, this whole thing gets beautiful. You see, I gave it a task in like one shot. I'm literally using these models as agents. I'm not using them as an LLM model. I really need to understand that. It's not about just getting an LLM model. It's about getting an LLM model which can access all the tools and really do multiple tasks at the same time using these tools. So now we are gone from the place that AI used to just reply in text, and then used to use some other tool to actually see this. Just look at this. This is really good, right? I'll have to verify the data and everything. Just the reason that I can get an image in a single prompt with everything is just crazy. And even the social media post is there, right? I mean, you already did that super quick. You have the whole content and the task done in one shot. So start using these models as agents rather than LLMs. And that's what my thought process changed since Mini got launched. And that's literally a big shift. So let's see. Who's holding India's income? The top 0.1% holds 22.5%. Top 1% holds 23.4%. Top 10% holds 42%. And bottom 90% owns 57%. The data looks a bit different. I will trust O3 on this, right? Given that it would have done a decent job, hopefully. Again, I don't want to verify right now on everything because India data is a bit different across. But you can see how well it has analyzed and given a lot of thought. The image that comes out here is very different compared to what came out here. This is the image that I would actually love. Like, this is the image that I would expect to be published on social media so that people can actually understand this. But this is a good one. One thing I don't understand, you know, bottom 90% hair holds 57%. In the image, it holds 37%. What's the right one? And then again, you see the problem with the image that it is not right in 30 to 40. It is actually middle of 20 to 30 or something. But that's fine. The images are still coming up. But just the idea that you can do it in one shot is crazy, right? Like, how much of it the India does, visual elements done and ready to post, content also created. And that's great. The idea that you can one shot an agent into existence is crazy. Okay, so let's come to another one of the tasks, and which I really am waiting to check is this image, right? So I just saw this on X and I wanted to check, okay, what do I do? Can I copy this image and ask it replicate, or I want to type two things, analyze the image and replicate the complete design in a single HTML file using JS and CSS and HTML. Right, I'm just going to copy paste this, paste it in both the place, and I want to ask it to literally just go ahead and analyze the image. And if it can go ahead and analyze the image and create a new landing page which is as close to it as, that's probably, like, you know, where we start seeing that images is how we think about the world. You see a specs case, a microphone case or something like that, that's how we interpret the world. If AI starts doing that really well, then we are all going to be a bit happier. And also just able to see AGI really coming together very soon, right? Just the idea that if AI can interpret a lot of this content in image format is crazy, because that's how we visualize the world and that's what we are trying to replicate here. Now, again, I think O4 Mini already came out with the whole thing, but I technically put it in the canvas. put the code in a canvas. And that's something that I have seen O4 missing a lot. Like, it does not understand, like, if it's code, you will see O3 just putting it in the canvas. But O4 always needs a push again, or probably I have to define it at the start that put this in a canvas. And that could be just based on the way the system prompts are set up for either of them, right? You can see on the left hand side, O3 is still analyzing. I can see that. You can see O3 is still analyzing everything. It has done like a couple of iteration of thoughts and then finally going to create it. And then that's where, like, you know, you see that it has thought for 1 minute 23 seconds, and this is what we get here. This is pretty close. This is super close to the design that I got again from X. This is the design and this is what we have got. Obviously the font is a bit different and everything else, the icons are not there, but just like, you know, can I switch theme? Oh my god, you can see this, you can see my face right now, right? Like, just the ability that it actually created, that just crazy, right? That's super fun. I did not expect that, right? And I'm just now waiting for O3 to get completed to actually see what does this look like. But now just imagine the whole idea about, you can copy and paste any designer, you can ask it to create a design cell and then code it out as a landing page. Oh my god, I wasn't expecting this at all. Does it work? Oh my god, they did actually. And I want to try it. It did build the search part also. That's so cool. If you search for 2025 payments, I am blown away. I am quite literally blown away, because I was just expecting a stupid landing page. This has just given that your first landing page within one shot of a prompt has, like, again, just look at this. It's crazy, right? It lets me open a console and everything, but I don't need a console. I just need to go back and see how does that look. Let me open that as chart. Let's see. Yep, this is the one for me. So you can see it's one shot just to put it in the canvas, and that's pretty much it. So let's see, what does O3 come up with? My hopes are high now. Allow network access, yes. Oh my god, this is amazing. I get it now. Technically, like, you know, here is where, like, you know, here is like a bit of nuance, right? Like, this is just that bit of nuance that I would have loved. You can see that actually this did not come that close. This did not come design wise 110% much better, but functionality wise from a page perspective, O4 mini blows this away in water. You have a better font, but that's just a thing. This has functionality, and that's where you see on simple prompts, you don't know which model will actually blow your way. O3 not done well. From a task perspective, it did extremely well. That bit of hallucination that AI models have, it's okay, because that hallucination allows you to get stuff like this, which has a switch theme, which has the thing that's already working and everything else. And that's the idea. But here, given that O3 was super specific, this is what it was asked of me. I replicate the complete images in one shot. You can see it added small boxes of design. So if I expand this a bit more, it does not get expanded. You can see it has these boxes of design which have some icons. And if I go ahead and say, like, make both the color schemes switchable in a single page and create a single landing page, it will be able to do that, right? Again, it will automatically be able to do this super quickly, and probably we'll love that. But O4 mini will probably be a bit more higher on hallucination and just gives you this beautiful things, right? So again, it's a feature at the end of the day. I always believe hallucination is a feature, and I'm just blown away by what is possible with AI right now. Okay, so finally O3 did it. I faced a ton of errors, and I don't think this find our app is working. So if you would see, I just asked it to put it in canvas, then it first put it in a canvas hole as a box and everything, but now after this wasn't able to render anything. Probably, like, you know, again, I don't know, the context would have gone out, but this is what it came like. I can switch themes now, but it's still not as good as what we got here in one shot. That just goes to show that sometimes we need those happy options. I would not even have thought about this theme thing. I was just trying to recreate stuff, but this looks pretty cool. The ability that you can do that is crazy. So now, what's the conclusion? And just to show you some stats, right? Now, this is the place where you can read about O3 and everything that they said, but actually this just changed a lot of things. And that's most important is this. We can see O3 on, like, you know, cost versus performance scale, O4 mini is the best model, and it's actually really, really cheap. And then you will see quality wise, 110% O3 is going to be beating O1 a lot. And the idea that you are able to beat that is crazy in 6-7 months from now, once we got adopted to O1 and now O3. And the best thing that I technically want to show you is, like, they really have cracked some of the best problems that there were, right? They actually also solved a lot of coding specific benchmarks and really made, and this is their own benchmark which they created for Lancet, which is about taking actual real problems and how much can these models make money by solving those problems. So they take problems from platforms like Fiverr and Upwork and then test the models, how much can they complete? And you can see O3 High was able to complete $65,000 worth of problems, and O4 Mini was able to complete $56,000 of problems. So that means in the very near future, we will have these agents which will just be available, and probably like a platform like Upwork create their own agent. So as soon as you post a request that this is what needs to be done, automatically an agent will say, okay, here is mock-up. If you say yes, I'll do this for $20, else you can hire a human for probably like $40, $50, $60, $100 or something like that. And that's going to really happen, and that's where we have to reimagine how the working process and everything that we work in the future changes, right? So that's really, really crazy. And again, highly great on multimodal reasoning. You could see that it just took an image and actually rendered the page word for word and pixel roughly, and really understand that better. So all in all, it's a great win on the whole AI front that was able to take so much content and then finally bring us to this beautiful outcome of doing everything that you would be doing on a daily basis and just making it 10x better. So kudos to OpenAI. I can't wait to see what comes out in O4, like, you know, not the O4 mini, but what is O4 and what does the next generation of models look like. Please like, share and subscribe. It really helps me out a lot, and I would love to see you in the next one.